is a tax the Christian and the Jew were paying when they were living under Islamic law.
Wait,
as a Christian, it's important.
What is important?
Talk about the jizya.
It's important. What is
important? Because we are supposed to pay jizya and the Islamic state.
To who?
Yeah. It's important.
It's important.
We're not paying tax in this country.
No, we're not talking about that. We're talking about jizya.
Okay, it's jizya tax.
Exactly. Yeah.
Jizya tax.
Yeah.
Show us in the Quran where it's jizya tax.
Sorry?
Show us where it's a tax. That's a tax.
Yeah? You said you don't speak from your head, yeah? Reference.
So what was that? Saudi, what's that? Saudi Bukhari?
Which one is it? Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, which one?
So when you're talking about Bukhari and Muslim, they are hadith.
Which one is that?
That is hadith. This is the glorious Quran.
Okay,
which has no version. Only one all over the world.
So
one Quran.
You have many.
One Quran all over the world. Not like Bible that got more than 40 different versions. Not like Bible that got more than 40 versions.
Okay.
Wait a second. You see, when you Muslim, when you see us coming out here, why the Muslim come out here? We want to bring the Christian out of the darkness into light.
Okay, bring us into light. Bring us into light. Go.
Because the Jesus you're talking about, that is not what is going to give you heaven.
Okay.
We want to give you what can give you.
Get killed. That's what we do. If we don't pay, we'll get killed. That's what it is.
If we don't
pay, we'll get killed.
You get killed.
We'll get killed. Is that what you're in a Muslim country?
I'm coming.
Yes. Under the Sharia law.
Yes or no?
Under the Sharia law.
Wait. Yeah, under the Sharia law.
Yes.
If you break the law.
If we don't pay the jizya.
If you break the law.
How do you break the law? By not paying it.
Okay.
If you are not ready.
Show us what
you're not ready. If you are not ready.
Don't make excuses.
Don't make excuses.
I'm not the kind of person that hug you blindly. I want to show you exactly what you need to do for you to believe in Jesus.
Okay, show
that
us,
is my purpose of being here.
Show us what you're reading.
It's not about phony.
Let me bring you down. Show us.
We are down.
You see, a lot of people are here. They talk blindly. Without any reference from the book
answer
of God.
Like you.
The Christian. What do you respect? Answer the question. Respect to you. Answer with that.
Yeah, answer what?
Talk about the jizya.
Jesus is a tag. The Christian prayer and Jew.
Show us.
929. No.
Yeah.
Read Surah 929.
Yeah. Can you read it for us?
Fight against those who believe not in the law, not in the last day, nor forbid that which Allah has forbidden by Allah and His Messenger Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and those who acknowledge not the religion of Islam among the people of the Scripture, Judah and Christ, until they pay jizya.
Right.
If they don't believe in Islam, they pay jizya for them to live under Islamic law.
Right. The Christian
they were not saying they should be killed.
Wait 10 minutes.
Can I respond to what you just said?
Yeah.
The question initially, my friend, what's your name, sir?
Abdul Razak.
Yeah. My name is Godwin. Yeah?
Yeah.
The question I initially asked you, okay, is show us where it's a tax, where they understood it as a tax. And you said, hold on. It's a tax.
Yeah, tax,
Jesus. Yeah. Okay? I don't want hearsay, I don't want what your imam says, I don't even know if you're an imam. I want to know where is it. In your sources where it shows that the jizya is actually a tax, okay? Because according to your sources, we don't have any information showing that it was a tax. What it was extortion. It was a humiliation payment, okay? That Christians and Jews would have to pay. Sir, let me finish what I'm saying, yeah? Was a humiliation. So the options were these. Either you are forced to convert into Islam, or you pay this jizya, or you are killed. Okay? So those are the three options. Now, me as a Christian, I believe that Allah is not God. He's a, and Muhammad is a false prophet. So therefore, I would not convert to be a Muslim. Therefore, if I'm living in a under the Sharia law in a Muslim country, I should be killed simply for the fact that I don't pay the jizya, which is not a tax. It's a humiliation. It's to show. It's to make this degrade a subdued someone who, you know, who doesn't believe what you believe. And I can, and let me just read the sources. Let me read the sources to substantiate from your Saudi Saudi Bukhari and Bantu. Can I read those to you? Okay. So let's read some sources. Okay. Very important. Okay. So let's start off with me. Okay. Bank it. Okay. Obviously, the world knows the content. Right. So he says this about the Sunnah for the land. Allah said, if they, so he's talking about the beast Jesus, if they do not treat the grace of Islam with willing submission, with obedience and subservience, and feel themselves true, disgraced, humiliated, and belittled, therefore, Muslims are not allowed to honor the people of Dimya, which is obviously Dimya's and Dimya's, or elevate them above Muslims. If they are miserable, disgraced, and humiliated. Okay? Let me read you some more. This is the from the Battles of the Prophets, page 183 and 4. Okay, it says, Allah Most High ordered believers to prohibit the disbelievers from entering or coming near the sacred mosque. On that Quraishi, Quraish thought that this would reduce their prophets. Okay? They're the prophets of their nations right now. Therefore, Allah Most High compensated them and ordered them to fight the people of the book until they embraced Islam or paid the jizya. That was spoken about. I have to kill them, pay the jizya. Allah says, O ye who believe, truly the buildings are clean, so let them not after this year or theirs approach the sacred mosque, and if you fear poverty, soon will Allah enrich you if he wills. For Allah is all knowing, all wise. Fight those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden, which have been forbidden by Allah and his messenger, nor is the religion of truth among the people of the book, until they pay jizya with willing submission and feel themselves subdued. Therefore, the messenger of Allah decided to fight the members in order to order to Islam. So now here you have this man, Muhammad, he's bringing this law, he's saying fight the Romans, he's saying unless in order to order to Islam. So they have three options at hand. And so, according to your most authentic sources, what is it? Blood tax? Was it humiliation and extortion? Where Muslims, or Dhimmis, would be living in a Muslim land and they had to make a payment to the Muslims. And if they didn't make that payment or convert to Islam, they would be killed. And so this is what Muslims are doing.
Muhammad was forcing people to accept Islam. Is that not what you're saying? They're calling to him. I'm coming, I'm coming. He was told to force people to embrace Islam. I now want to tell you, in Quran chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah verse 256, Allah told Muhammad that there is no confusion in religion. The truth, I'm coming. Can you listen to this? Why are you doing like a beggar? We are trying to call you to Jesus, but you refuse to accept it. Listen. You need to listen. Allah says to Muhammad, may there be no compulsion in religion, the truth distinct from the wrong part. In Quran chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah verse 272, Allah says, Muhammad, the guardian is not with you. We are only instructed to call people. Whether they accept it or not, you are less concerned. It is the law. Who will guide? Who will guide? Who will go to the right path? In Quran chapter 4, throughout the Islam, verse 80, Allah said, Muhammad, whoever obeyed Muhammad, peace be upon him, he has indeed obeyed Allah. If they turn away from you, we have not sent you as a watcher over them. In Quran chapter 16, verse 82, throughout the Quran, Allah said, Muhammad, we are only sent you to convey the message. Whether they accept it or not, you are less concerned. In Quran chapter 88, verse 21 and 22, Muhammad, are you the one to compel them to accept Islam? We are not sent for that. Then about jihad, the Prophet was fighting, they were fighting with the pagans of Mecca, not the Christians and the Jews, pagans of Mecca. And the first ayah that was referring to the jihad to fight against them was Quran chapter 2, verse 190, 191. Allah says, Quran chapter 2, verse 190. Allah says, fight those who fight you in the cause of Allah. Those who fight in the cause of Allah. And when Quran chapter 2, verse 190, fight and come in as one of Allah, the first ayah, the first referring to jihad against the idolatry worship by Mecca. Fight those who fight you in the cause of Allah. But when you are fighting them, don't transgress. Allah does not like the transgressor. In the Quran that was given to Muhammad. So the Jews were mentioned and the Christians were mentioned. Quran chapter 5, throughout the reminder, verse 82 and 83. Allah says, the Jews were the enemies of Muslims. The Christian, there's some Christian that was closer to the Muslims. Quran chapter 2, Quran chapter 5, verse 2 and 3. They were close to the Muslims because they believed in what was revealed to Muhammad.
Okay, sir, can we respond to what you're saying?
Muhammad?
How long have you been
coming? What was revealed to Muhammad?
You made a lot of points.
The oneness of God.
Okay.
So, what do you want to say?
Okay, so we just want to respond. Okay.
Yeah.
The problem you have here as a Muslim, yeah? You've got to choose now, right? Either one, you have a Quran which contradicts itself, where...
Quran contradicts.
Sir, did I disturb what you're talking? Either you have a Quran which contradicts itself, where clearly in Surah 929, where it's saying, fight those who do not believe unless they pay the jizya with willing submission, or you have one who says there's no compulsion under religion. That's contradiction. Or you have what the Ibn Kathir says,
Surah 2, yep, abrogated.
Which
by
one?
The fighting verse.
Wait.
The one you just quoted.
The one you quoted, Surah 2,
verse 190. No, one.
You quoted Surah 2, 256 up to 190.
Yeah.
That's been cancelled by the fighting verse. That's Ibn Kathir. I can read to you.
We're finished.
Let me give you one.
Not yet. Respectfully, respectfully.
You see, the one that was changed. Let me give you this. Quran chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 106. Quran chapter 16, Surah Al-Nahl, verse 101. No. Allah said, any ayat, any verses of the Quran we abrogate, or the one we cause to be forgotten, we will bring the one that's similar to it, or the one that is better than it. When you said that one was cancelled, 256 was cancelled, which one Allah abrogated which?
Surah 9, Surah 973, the whole Surah 9 actually, abrogated by the fighting verse.
Yes.
This is Ibn Kathir talking. Yeah, and he said, everyone should be called to Islam. If they refuse to do so, kill them.
Okay, so let me continue now. Okay,
Ibn Abbas.
So clearly you can see that he was mistaken there. So let me continue on what I'm speaking about into all contradiction. Okay, so let me talk about this jizya. Okay, let me continue with your sources. Sahih Bukhari, okay, 453, 388. All right, so we say to Umar bin Al-Khattab, O chief of believers, advise us. He said, I advise you to fulfill Allah's convention made with the dhimmis,
yes,
as it is the convention of your prophet and the source of your livelihood of your dependence. Okay? So what he's saying is that it was their source, it was their revenue. It's like when you have like the mafia, when they go around collecting payments of people, okay, who they're trying to humiliate or they're trying to raise revenue in order to do whatever they're doing, okay? This is what it was. It wasn't a tax. It was simply them some extortion money that they were able to collect. And this was not for Muslims to pay. This was the ones who they were humiliating, which are the Christians, the Jews. But there was a clause, there was a way out. that was for them to convert to Islam. And so, and so over and over again, throughout your sources, even in the Quran, it states clearly and explicitly that the jizya is for those who are not Muslim, and it's to humiliate them. Do you understand that? Okay.
I told you initially, I said I'm not here for argument. I'm just here to prove what is right to you. Look at what Allah said regarding the Christian that was closer to the Muslim at the time of Prophet Muhammad.
Okay. What did he say?
Look at what
is this to do with the jizya?
You're going somewhere else.
Are you going somewhere else now?
What do you exactly want to do with jizya? I've told you already what the jizya means. And I've told you Muhammad cannot enforce Islam on people. Muhammad cannot enforce Islam on people.
We just read to you. Let me keep reading. Wait, 1 second.
Don't keep reading.
Hold on. No, but you don't seem to get what we're saying to you.
Sorry.
He forced people to convert to Islam.
Let me give one thing.
What the part do you understand?
You claim to be following Jesus.
Are you changing the subject?
I'm coming. You claim to be following Jesus, isn't it?
You're changing the subject.
I'm coming. You claim to be following Jesus, isn't it?
What does that got to do with jizya?
In the book of Matthew chapter 12. Wait. Matthew chapter 12.
Now we're talking about Matthew.
Wait.
Is it jizya in Matthew?
I want to give you one thing. One important thing. I want to give you an advice.
What's Matthew?
In the book of Matthew chapter 12 verse 36. Jesus said, all the foolish word men shall speak in this world against prophet, against God, they shall come for it in the after. They will come for it in the after.
Yeah.
You have to mind what you are saying about prophet. You will never see a Muslim talking foolishness about Jesus. Peace be upon him.
You know what Jesus said about
because,
Muhammad?
What did he say?
He said he's a false prophet.
Sorry?
Matthew 24, verse 42 to 44.
It was
Jesus. Muhammad is a false prophet.
I'm coming. Yes. In the book of Matthew chapter 24, this is what Jesus said.
I don't know why you're coming.
Before we continue, the subject, hold on, the subject is about the jizya. Now, hold on, wait. Now, if we want to change the subject, speak about something else, we're fine to do that. Let's conclude this, let's put that away, and we'll talk about another subject. But I don't want you to be diverting or try to use some kind of red herring and try to throw it on the Bible. What I'm asking you is this, if you understand what we've explained to you, hopefully you go away and you use that information and knowledge to look more into Islam and understand
more
that
into Islam.
Islam, hold on, and understand that you're following a false religion that's you're currently leading you to hell. And so now what we'll do now is we can go to another subject. If you've understood that. Or do you want to continue on this?
On what? On jizya.
On the jizya. Or do you want to continue?
Muhammad forced people. Your prophet forced people to pay this money.
My dad was born into Christianity. My dad was born into Christianity. He converted into Islam. His sister is still a Christian tomorrow, and we are doing things together.
Okay.
Allah says in Quran chapter 60.
Do you agree? Do you agree?
You're going against your Quran.
Allah says, oh Muslim. Allah says, oh Muslim. Allah has never forbid you for being just and do good to people outside your religion.
Okay. Why did the Quran say Jews and Christians are the worst of creatures?
Because they call him God, they call Jesus, they call Jesus God. They are the worst of creation.
So there's a contradiction in your Quran.
No, you call Jesus, you call Jesus God.
What did you say in the beginning?
The most high, the most great.
What did you say in the beginning? What did you say in the beginning?
Sorry,
the Christians, they're the best people.
Are the worst of creation?
No. You said in Surah 5, Allah said the Christians are good people.
What did you say? I'm coming.
Surah 98:6.
Let me explain this to you.
Are you listening to what he's saying? Are you listening?
Let me explain this to you. You see the one I quoted from Surah Al-Maida, verse 293.
Yeah.
The Christian then, the Tawheed, oneness of God was given to Prophet Muhammad for a good 13 years. He was preaching that in Mecca for 13 good years. He was preaching to people to accept God as one. So those Christian then, people like Waraka was Khadija, the first wife of the Prophet's cousin. He believed in what was given to Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he was preaching oneness of God for 13 years. And the Christian then, they believed in what was given to Prophet Muhammad because they recognized what was given to them.
So there's a contradiction.
I'm coming. When Jesus was preaching to people in the book of Mark chapter 12, verse 28 to 29, which I quoted, that Christian I quoted, they believe in what was revealed to Muhammad. That was Allah says. Okay.
All due respect. All due respect. Do you understand what he's asking you? Do you understand it? Because it seems that we're talking past each other. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. He made a statement to you. He's saying in your Quran, as you said, it says that the Christians are the worst of creation. Yeah. Okay. Right. Surah 98 verse 6. Right. Okay. But then on the other hand. You're saying, what are you saying? You're saying something completely different.
The Christians are best.
The Christians are best.
Surah 98.
Right.
Surah 98. Surah 98. Surah 98. I'm coming. Okay. Let me say what is there.
Wait, do you understand
that? Surah 98 verse 5 to 7. Allah said, Quran chapter 98, verse 5 to 7. Surah Al-Bahina.
And 7 says,
Allah said, I'm best of people are Muslims. Allah says, they have not been commanded more than to make salah for Allah, to worship Allah alone, and to pay zakat. The deal of the poor to pay it. And this is a religion, this is a true religion before God.
Okay.
Those who disbelieve among the people of the Bush, Jews and the Christians, and the pagans, they are the worst of the creation.
Okay.
All right. So,
finish it.
Verse 7, yeah. Those who believe
and
do what we have been commanded, they are the people, they are the poor doers.
Muslims, yeah?
Yeah, the Muslims.
The Muslims are the best.
Yeah, they are the best.
The Christians and the Jews are the worst.
Yeah. Right. So, are you not the worst? Okay. I can prove to you you are the worst.
Do you understand? Now, do you understand why this jizya, if you let me finish, this jizya was put upon these Christians? Reason why they were to be humiliated in this way is because they believe that Muslims, or that they believe that Christians were the worst of creation, and clearly Muslims were superior to Christians. Now it confuses me because yeah, exactly.
You don't know what you're talking about.
What I'm saying to you is, you say we can't prove it, but we have proof. We've given you commentators of Islam, well-respected commentators. We've given you hadiths, the most authentic hadiths you have. We've given you the Quran itself to show clearly, that Christians are inferior, according to the Quran, according to your sources, that if Christians are inferior and that they should be humiliated, unless
they should be humiliated.
Hold on, unless they convert, and the other option is to be killed. So, in other words, if all of us were living in a Muslim country right now, if as Christians we don't believe in Allah is God, and we don't believe Muhammad is a prophet, we believe he's a false prophet.
We don't believe Muhammad is a false prophet.
Hold on. Therefore, according to the Sharia, we should be killed. Now,
or pay the jizya
to be humiliated. Okay, so that Muslims can get more wealthy.
Yeah.
That's what it was for. Now, you haven't refuted that in any way. All you've done is go to Matthew. You've gone to different parts of the Bible. You've changed the subject on several occasions.
Yeah.
You spoke about the oneness of God, and you haven't been consistent. And all I'll say to you is this, is as a Muslim, go and look into this information, go and look into what we spoke to you about, and you see that truly, Islam is not the way. Jesus Christ is the way. And the Bible says in the book of John 14, and you know this, John 14, 6, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me, not through Muhammad. Muhammad's a false prophet. Let me finish. My brother mentioned, Jesus Christ himself said that in the last days many false prophets will come, and they will deceive many. Muhammad came along, and today we have 1.5 billion deceived Muslims all over the world. And so we're here just to call you to, you say you called people to Islam, we're here to give you the gospel truth, the good news, that you don't have to die in your sin. Come out of the darkness, come to Jesus Christ.
Can I talk now?
Yeah, sure.
This is the Bible. We the Christian believe in. This book was not coming to the system until 325 years after Jesus departed from the world. Jesus said, I am the way,
the truth and the life. No one come to the Father except by me. John chapter 14 from verse 1.
Do you agree with that statement? Do you agree with that? Yeah. So you agree? Shake my hand, brother.
Let me talk.
Jesus,
let
the truth. No. Shake my hand. Please, just shake my hand. That's all. Because you said that Jesus is the truth. Yes, I do. Shake my hand.
Shake him.
Jesus is the truth. Who's the truth in the Quran? Who's the truth in the Quran? Who's the truth? Only Allah is the truth. Definite article. Right. So Jesus is him to be true. Jesus, you agreed, the truth. Let me bring it to Jesus.
You need to relax yourself.
We're excited about Jesus. We love Jesus so much.
The Bible says, Isaiah chapter 1 verse 18. What did
you
say?
Isaiah.
Matthew, Isaiah. You're all over the place, man.
Let's stick to one book.
Let's stick to one book.
Your book says, the book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse 18. Let us reason together.
What are we doing now?
1 Thessalians chapter 5, verse 21, your book. Your book says.
Are you the black Zakir Naik? Don't just quote scriptures.
Be yourself.
It
doesn't look good when you're like Zakir Naik. This is Zakir Naik. This is
Ahmadidad.
Be yourself.
I'm coming.
Don't go to Thessalonians.
You know what Allah says to the Quran? You know what Allah says to the Muslim? Quran chapter 29, Surah Al-Ankabut, verse 46. Allah said, argue not with the people of the Buddha, the Jews, and the Christians.
So do not
accept in the way that.
Why are you arguing? Why are you arguing?
You are blind. I'm trying to guide you.
Okay. I appreciate the conversation. Let's end the conversation, yeah?
Okay. What's your name?
No, leave it.
What do you want to do, my woman? I want to guide you, but you are not.
Let's summarize.
You are not guided. Because you know that what I'm saying.
Okay, sir, we appreciate it. God bless you. Take it.
I'm not here to hug you. You are here to hug you, but I'm not arguing.
Okay.
I'm doing the responsibility which Allah said I should do for you.
We'll raise this round up in a minute. One minute. We'll just go round up. Okay, listen, let's round up. Let's just round up. Okay. So the reason why I'm here today is because we love Muslims. I want to point them to the truth of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, my Muslim brother here, you know, praise be to God. We read the scripture, John chapter 14, verse 6, which Jesus clearly stated. But Jesus said, I am the way.
Yes.
Definite article. Not I'm a way. Yeah. I'm the way.
I'm still here waiting.
I thought we're running off now.
I'm still here waiting, but we are not.
Hold on.
I'm still going to talk.
So he said, he's the way, he's the truth, and it's the life. No man comes to the Father except through him.
Amen.
Now, notice he said it's the truth. Now, I think it's the Al-Aq. According to the Quran, okay? Only Allah claimed that title. Yes. You cannot be the truth. You might say you're a truth, but it's an indefinite article. Jesus Christ claimed to be the truth, the title that belongs only to God.
Amen.
And my Muslim brother admitted that today, which I shook his hand for. But the initial conversation was about the jizya. The jizya, if you know anything about the jizya is a payment. It's an extortion payment to those who will not convert to Islam. Now, in those days, what you'd have is you'd have Muhammad and his raiders who'd go around looting various places and various caravans and so on and so forth. And what would happen is that they would run out of money. I said they needed revenue, and so Allah apparently gave this Surah 9 revelation to Muhammad and told him that, listen, you know what? You can gain extra income. What you need to do is you put this jizya upon Muslims and Jews, Christians and Jews living in the area, okay? And so they have to make this payment,
and it wouldn't be
Muslims, okay? And so here you have these Christians who have to pay this amount of money, otherwise they would be killed and humiliated.
What I'm simply saying to them is this,
following a religion where you're forced okay? So Christians, doesn't make any sense. Jesus Christ has given you the option, he's given you that free choice, that free will. Come to me. His arms are stretched open to you, okay? It's not by anything, it's not by any works, it's not by you doing good deeds.